يَدْعُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ He invokes instead of Allah that which neither harms him nor benefits him. That is what is the extreme error. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الضَّلَالُ الْبَعِيدُ He invokes one whose harm is closer than his benefit. Meaning when he leaves Islam, when he leaves Allah, when he leaves the book of Allah, then what is he doing? Wasting his life. How wretched the protector and how wretched the associate. Indeed, Allah will admit those who believe and do righteous deeds to gardens beneath which rivers flow. Just hold on a little longer. Yes, life is tough. It is difficult. But keep believing, keep doing good. And Allah will not waste you. Indeed, Allah does what He intends. Whoever should think that Allah will not support him in this world and the hereafter, then let him extend a rope to the ceiling. Then cut off his breath. Meaning cut off that rope and kill himself. And let him see, will his effort remove that which enrages him? Meaning those who say that Allah doesn't help. Because sometimes it happens that a person is in difficulty, all right, and they're told, make dua. And they say, no, no, my duas are not answered. Allah does not answer duas. Okay, what's the other option? What's the other option? Try doing this. If you think that Allah will not support you, Allah will not help you, He will not answer your duas, then what's the other option? Not make dua? Okay, don't make dua. Okay, get angry with Allah. Okay, leave Allah. Don't worship Him. Then, and you know what? In your anger and frustration, go kill yourself. Will that solve the problem? No. Remember the three companions who stayed behind from Tabuk? The ayat about them in the Quran, وَظَنُّوا أَلَّا مَلْجَأَ مِنَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا إِلَيْهِ There is no refuge, no shelter from Allah except with Allah. You cannot run away from Allah. There's no other option because there is no co-equal to Allah. So if we want our du'as answered, we have to call upon only Allah. Never ever give up. Because giving up means losing yourself. Only harming yourself. Destroying yourself. So in other words, what we are being told to do over here is be patient and keep worshipping Allah with sabr, with sabat. Allah tests His servants to see how determined they are. Look at Ibrahim alayhi salam. When was his dua answered? Right? Zakariya alayhi salam. All the prophets of Allah. What do we learn from their lives? They never lost faith in Allah. They were kullu min as-sabirin. They were all patient servants of Allah. They never gave up. And this is what we need to do also. And thus have we sent down the Qur'an as verses of clear evidence. And because Allah guides whom He intends. Indeed, those who have believed, and those who were Jews, and the Sabians, and the Christians, and the Magians, and those who associated with Allah, Allah will judge between them on the day of resurrection. Indeed, Allah is over all things witness. Because right now, everybody claims to be right. So who's right? Who's on the truth? Allah will clarify on the day of judgment. Meaning those who don't accept the Qur'an, of course, they will never find guidance. Right? They will never find the truth. So then what to do? Can you solve this problem? For those who are not willing to accept the guidance that Allah has sent. You can't solve it here. Now you just have to wait for the Day of Judgment. Do you not see that to Allah prostrates whoever is in the heavens and whoever is on the earth? And the sun, the moon, the stars, the mountains, the trees, the moving creatures and many of the people? But among many, the punishment has been justified. They refuse to prostrate to Allah. And he whom Allah humiliates, for him there is no bestower of honor. Indeed, Allah does what He wills. Just look at the massive size of the things that are mentioned over here. The sun, the moon, the stars, mountains, trees, they prostrate to Allah. We don't. If we don't, we're only harming ourselves. These are two adversaries who have disputed over their Lord. One group is of those who disbelieved. What's going to happen to them? Allah says, those who disbelieved will have cut out for them garments of fire. Meaning their clothing in fire, made of fire, is already cut. Made to fit. Tailored to fit. Poured upon their heads will be scalding water, by which is melted that within their bellies and their skins. And for striking them are maces of iron. Every time they want to get out of hellfire from anguish, they will be returned to it. And it will be said, taste the punishment of the burning fire. Jahannam is not something insignificant. It is the worst of all places. The worst of all places. The worst of all punishments, ultimate pain, ultimate suffering is in hell. This is why we must avoid, we must leave anything and everything that takes to hell. And if a mistake happens, go back to Allah and seek His forgiveness. Never persist in that sin. Don't stay there. Go back to Allah. And the other group, Allah says, indeed, Allah will admit those who believe and do righteous deeds to gardens beneath which rivers flow. They will be adorned therein with bracelets of gold and pearl. They will be adorned, they will be beautified. And their garments therein will be of silk. When you wear silk, do you wash dishes? No, you don't. Why? Because then your silk will get damaged. So if they'll be wearing silk in Jannah, it means they are forever in comfort and luxury, never having to do anything. وَهُدُوا إِلَى الطَّيِّبِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ وَهُدُوا إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْحَمِيدِ. And they had been guided in worldly life to good speech. They were guided to good speech. What is the good speech? لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And also the Qur'an. They were guided to the Qur'an. You see, we can only be guided to something if we want to be guided. Like for example, if someone says, follow me, right? I'll drive in front of you, you drive behind me. All right, follow my car, I'll take you to the gas station. And you're like, okay. And then, as they drive in front of you, you say, no. What do they know? I'm not going to follow them. Can you be led? No. When is it that we can be led? When we are willing to be led. When we are willing to follow. So, وَهُدُوا إِلَى الطَّيِّبِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ. What does it imply? That when they were taken to the Qur'an, they also accepted the Qur'an. They followed it. When they were invited to the Qur'an, they accepted that invitation. وَهُدُوا إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْحَمِيدِ. And they were guided to the path of the praiseworthy. What is that path? The path of Allah. What is that path? The path that Allah likes. The path that takes one to Allah's approval. And where do you find that? Through the Qur'an. So when they accepted the invitation to the Qur'an, they followed it, they adopted it, so they were on the path of Allah. Going to Allah's pleasure. What does it show to us? That when a person accepts the good word, he likes it, he makes space for it in his heart, then Allah will guide him to the best ways and also give him firmness. Indeed, those who have disbelieved and avert people from the way of Allah and from al-Masjid al-Haram, which we have made for the people equal. We have made for the people, which al-Masjid al-Haram, equal are the resident therein, and one from outside. Meaning it doesn't matter whether a person is a resident of Makkah or an outsider, a foreigner, everyone has a right to it. And also whoever intends a deed therein of deviation in religion or wrongdoing, we will make him taste of a painful punishment. And mention when we designated for Ibrahim the site of the house, saying, do not associate anything with me, and purify my house for those who perform tawaf, and those who stand in prayer, and those who bow and prostrate. What do we see here? Again, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was ordered to keep the house of Allah clean. So we should also be concerned about the cleanliness of the masjid. This was the work assigned to the Prophet, the Khalil of Allah. Cleaning the masjid is an act that is beloved to Allah. And its opposite is something that is disliked by Allah. The Prophet ﷺ said, the deeds of my people, good and bad, were presented before me. And I found the removal of something objectionable from the road among their good deeds. So removing something that's harmful from the road, that is a good deed. And the sputum, the mucus that was left unburied in the masjid among their sins. Meaning if a person spits in the masjid, and he just leaves it on the wall, then this is what? A sin. Dirtying the masjid is a sin. And it's sad that sometimes the desks that are being used to put the Qur'an on, under that, gum is found. Gum is found. This is a sin. Or dirty tissues with phlegm is left. This is something that's not acceptable. Dirtying the floor of the carpet of the masjid. Because remember that he who does not respect the cleanliness of the masjid, then he's not worthy of any honor. We learned that once a man was leading the people in prayer. And as he was praying, he spat towards the Qibla. He's leading. All right? And the Prophet ﷺ saw him doing that. He must not have been praying at that time. Right? And the Prophet ﷺ said to the people, when this man finished his prayer, he should not lead you in prayer again. He should not be your imam again. So when a person dirties the masjid, then he goes a step down in the sight of Allah. This is a serious matter. and proclaim to the people the Hajj. They will come. They will come to you on foot and on every lean camel. They will come from every distant pass, that they may witness benefits from themselves. And these benefits, they can only be known when a person actually goes for Hajj. They can only be known through experience. Make dua. Right? Even if you've done Hajj before, make dua, Ya Allah, take me again. Ramadan is the time when du'as are accepted. Every day. Every day a dua is accepted. Make dua, Ya Allah, I want to come visit your house. And mention the name of Allah on known days over what He has provided for them of sacrificial animals. Allah created the animals and Allah allowed us to eat them. So when we slaughter the animals, then we must mention only the name of Allah. So eat of them and feed the miserable and the poor. Then let them end their untidiness and fulfill their vows and perform tawaf around the ancient house. The rituals of Hajj are being mentioned. And tawaf is a very, very noble deed. The Prophet ﷺ said, he who goes around the Kaaba 7 times in a way that he does not say any lagu speech, meaning any extra speech, he doesn't say that at all. He just engages in the dhikr of Allah. Then he will get the reward of freeing one slave. That has been commanded. And whoever honors the sacred ordinances of Allah, وَمَن يُعَظِّمْ حُرُمَاتِ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ It is best for him in the sight of his Lord. And permitted to you are the grazing livestock, except what is recited to you. So avoid the uncleanliness of idols and avoid false statement. Meaning when you go for Hajj, keep away from any form of shirk. And for the rest of your life also, keep away from any form of shirk. Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. Ikhlas. And also we see over here in this ayah that فَاجْتَنِبُوا الرِّجْسَ مِنَ الْأَوْسَانِ وَاجْتَنِبُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ Avoid two things, and these two things are mentioned together. What are they? Idolatry and secondly, lying. Lying and idolatry are mentioned together. Lying and idolatry are mentioned together. This is something very serious. We don't think lying is a big deal. It's a major sin. Inclining only to Allah, not associating anything with Him. And he who associates with Allah, it is as though he had fallen from the sky and was snatched by the birds, or the wind carried him down into a remote place. What would become of this person? This is utter destruction. So likewise, when a person does shirk, he is only going for ruin. That is so. And whoever honors the symbols of Allah, indeed it is from the piety of the hearts. What are the symbols of Allah? Things that remind you of Allah, that are part of the deen, whether it is the Kaaba, a masjid, a hijab, a beard, Quran, all of these are sha'air of Allah, right? Tilawa, all of this. The one who respects them, that is from the piety of the heart. And the one who disrespects them, then what does it show? That person has fear of Allah? No way. For you, the animals marked for sacrifice are benefits for a specified term. Meaning in these animals that you take for sacrifice, there are many benefits for you. You can enjoy them. Then their place of sacrifice is at the ancient house. Meaning they are to be slaughtered at Mina. And for all religion, we have appointed a rite of sacrifice. Meaning previous nations were also ordered to offer sacrifice. The two sons of Adam a.s. إِذْ قَرَّبَ قُرْبَانٍ They also offered sacrifice. So this is not something new, that in Islam we have to take animals and we have to slaughter them. No. This is ritual slaughter that has been there from the beginning. That they may mention the name of Allah over what He has provided for them of sacrificial animals. For your God is one God. So to Him submit. And O Prophet, give good tidings to the humble before their Lord. وَبَشِّرِ الْمُخْبِتِينَ Who are those who are humble? Who, when Allah is mentioned, their hearts are fearful. They're not stubborn. They don't argue over there. And those who are patient over what has afflicted them. And those who establish the prayer. And those who spend from what we have provided them. These are the humble. Who's humble then? The one who's humble before Allah. And the camels and cattle we have appointed for you as among the symbols of Allah. Meaning these animals, when you're slaughtering them at Hajj, right? As a part of the ritual, don't just treat them as objects. No. These are among the symbols of Allah. For you therein is good. So mention the name of Allah upon them when lined up for sacrifice. And when they are lifeless on their sides, then eat from them and feed the needy and the beggar. Thus have we subjected them to you that you may be grateful. Meaning when you eat meat, Don't just think of it as meat. Think that this was an animal. Allah made halal for you. You mentioned Allah's name. And when you eat it, be grateful. Yesterday I was having this thought, I had a tuna steak. Okay, and it was really nice, tuna. And I'm like, you know, really, it made me feel this was a creature swimming in the sea. And it was caught and killed and brought here. Somebody sold it. Somebody bought it. And now I'm eating it. Allah allowed this. That a creature that was once living is now on my plate. This is Allah's ihsan. Don't forget that. It is only by His permission that we are able to enjoy these blessings. So be grateful. Their meat will not reach Allah, nor will their blood. Meaning when you slaughter animals, the blood and the meat doesn't reach Allah. But what reaches Him is piety from you. So what matters then? The apparent, it matters. But more than that, the state of the heart matters. Thus have we subjected them to you, that you may glorify Allah for that to which He has guided you. And give good tidings to the doers of good. وَبَشِّرِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Indeed, Allah defends those who have believed. Indeed, Allah does not like everyone treacherous and ungrateful. Who are those who are ungrateful? Ungrateful for Allah's blessings. So when you're in the way of Allah and you suffer at the hands of people, don't worry. Remember, Allah will defend you. Permission to fight has been given to those who are being fought because they were wronged. And indeed, Allah is competent to give them victory. There are those who have been evicted from their homes without right, only because they say, our Lord is Allah. And were it not that Allah checks the people, some by means of others, there would have been demolished monasteries, churches, synagogues, and mosques in which the name of Allah is much mentioned. Meaning then there would be total devastation on the earth. And Allah will surely support those who support Him. وَلَيَنْصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ. What is this promise? That Allah will help those who help Him. What a true promise. So never fear opposition in Allah's way. Never fear hardship in Allah's way. What we need to worry about is مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ. The one who helps Him. So we need to worry about our efforts, our work. What can I do? Where? How much? And Allah will take care of me. Indeed, Allah is powerful and exalted in might. And they are those who, if we give them authority in the land, they will establish prayer and give zakat and enjoin what is right and forbid what is wrong. And to Allah belongs the outcome of all matters. And if they deny you, so before them did the people of Nuh and Ad and Thamud deny their prophets. And the people of Ibrahim and the people of Lut and the inhabitants of Madian. And Musa was denied. So I prolonged enjoyment for the disbelievers. Then I seized them. And how terrible was my reproach. And how many a city did we destroy while it was committing wrong? So it is now fallen into ruin. They're buried under rubble, never found, never taken out. And how many an abandoned well, and how many a lofty palace. So have they not traveled through the earth, and have hearts by which to reason, and ears by which to hear? For indeed it is not eyes that are blinded, but blinded are the hearts which are within the breasts. And when the heart is blind, then the heart does not see reality as it is. What is a blind heart? Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, destroyed is the one whose heart does not recognize right as right and does not recognize wrong as wrong. Such a person is destroyed. Why? Because his heart is blind. It doesn't see things properly. So if the heart is not in the right place, if the position of the heart is not correct, then the rest of the body, the rest of the actions will also not be right. But if the heart is right, is rectified, then what will happen? The rest of the actions will also be fine. And they urge you to hasten the punishment. But Allah will never fail in His promise. And indeed, a day with your Lord is like 1,000 years of those which you count. Doesn't it happen in this world? You go from one place to the other. And time is different in the sense that 9 o'clock is bedtime for some people and 9 o'clock is Maghrib time for you. Right? So imagine the difference from planet to planet then. There would be a huge difference. And of course, our measures of time are very different from Allah's measure of time. And for how many a city did I prolong enjoyment while it was committing wrong? Then I seized it, and to me is the final destination. Say, O people, I am only to you a clear warner. إِنَّمَا أَنَا لَكُمْ نَذِيرٌ مُّبِينٌ. And those who believe, and they did righteous deeds, for them is forgiveness and a noble provision. They'll be served honorably also. You know, sometimes the food is really good, but the way it's served is really bad. Right? What do we see? What is kun kareem? In Jannah, the food is noble. And the way it is served is also very honorable. But the ones who strove against our verses, seeking to cause failure, those are the companions of hellfire. They will not receive any honor. And we did not send before you any messenger or prophet, except that when he spoke or recited, shaitan threw into it, meaning into his speech, some misunderstanding. Meaning shaitan tried his best to interfere and disturb the work of the messenger. But Allah abolishes that which shaitan throws in. Then Allah makes precise his verses, and Allah is knowing and wise. Meaning whatever efforts shaitan makes to disturb the work of the prophet, Allah destroys the efforts of shaitan. So have no fear. That is, so he may make what shaitan throws in a trial for those within whose hearts is disease, and those hard of hearts. And indeed, the wrongdoers are in extreme dissension. And so those who were given knowledge may know that it is the truth from your Lord, and therefore believe in it, and their hearts humbly submit to it. And indeed, is Allah the guide of those who have believed to a straight path. Despite the crafts of shaitan, some hearts are softened, they're guided. And other hearts, what happens to them? They remain hardened. Because you see, وَالْقَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ And over here, فَتُخْبِتَ لَهُ قُلُوبُهُمْ Hearts are different. So the same Qur'an, one person is deviated and the other is guided. But those who disbelieve will not cease to be in doubt of it until the hour comes upon them unexpectedly, or there comes to them the punishment of a barren day. All sovereignty that day is for Allah. He will judge between them. So they who believed and did righteous deeds will be in the gardens of pleasure. And they who disbelieved and denied our verses, for those there will be a humiliating punishment. And those who immigrated for the cause of Allah and then were killed or died, Allah will surely provide for them a good provision. And indeed, it is Allah who is the best of providers. Someone who suffers in Allah's way, we pity them. What do we see here? Allah provides for them. He will surely cause them to enter an entrance with which they will be pleased. And indeed, Allah is knowing and forbearing. That is so. And whoever responds to injustice with the equivalent of that, he was harmed and then is tyrannized, Allah will surely aid him. Indeed, Allah is pardoning and forgiving. That is because Allah causes the night to enter the day and causes the day to enter the night, and because Allah is hearing and seeing. So the situation that a person is in today, that will also change. That is because Allah is the truth, and that which they call upon other than Him is falsehood. And because Allah is the Most High, the Grand, هُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْكَبِيرُ Do you not see that Allah has sent down rain from the sky and the earth becomes green? Indeed, Allah is subtle and acquainted. So every decision of Allah is the best. We don't know how the benefits come, but they come. I mean, when water falls from the sky, you would think that the grass is getting flooded. Right? That there's such heavy rain falling, you would think that your very delicate flowers and herbs, they would die. But then what happens? The next day you go and see they're blooming. Amazing. So likewise, Allah's hukum is the best. We don't know how the benefit comes. It comes. Inna Allah latif, khabir. To Him belongs what is in the heavens and what is on the earth. And indeed Allah is the free of need, the praiseworthy. Do you not see that Allah has subjected to you whatever is on the earth and the ships which run through the sea by His command? And He restrains the sky from falling upon the earth unless by His permission. There's so much out there in space. And so much good fall on the earth. Who's protecting us? Allah. Indeed, Allah to the people is kind and merciful. And He is the one who gave you life, then He causes you to die, and then will again give you life. Indeed, mankind is ungrateful. For every religion we have appointed rituals which they perform. Meaning every ummah was given a set of rituals. So, O Prophet, let the disbelievers not contend with you over the matter, but invite them to your Lord. Indeed, you are upon straight guidance. Because people wonder, why do you Muslims eat like this and wear this and don't do this and do that instead? Well, this is the law that Allah gave. And Allah gave law to every nation. Meaning before the nation of Muhammad ﷺ. Musa ﷺ came with the law, right? And if they dispute with you, then say, Allah is most knowing of what you do. Allah will judge between you on the day of resurrection concerning that over which you used to differ. Do you not know that Allah knows what is in the heaven and the earth? Indeed, that is in a record. Indeed, that for Allah is easy. So He knows, and He has also got everything recorded. And they worship besides Allah that for which He has not sent down authority, and that of which they have no knowledge. And there will not be for the wrongdoers any helper. And when our verses are recited to them as clear evidences, you recognize in the faces of those who disbelieve disapproval. They hear the Qur'an and they get upset. They're almost on the verge of assaulting those who recite to them our verses. They get so angry. Say, then shall I inform you of what is worse than that? It is the fire which Allah has promised those who disbelieve. And wretched is the destination. Meaning you're angry now? You'll see something that's more angry than the fire of rage that's burning in you. And what is that angry fire? It's the fire of hell. Ya ayyuha an-nas, O people, all people are addressed. Duriba mathalun fastami'u lah. An example is presented, so listen to it. All of us are asked to listen to this carefully. Innal ladina tad'una min dunillah lan yakhluqu dhubaban wa law ijtama'u bih. Indeed, those you invoke besides Allah, whom you think more capable of helping you, you think that they respond more than Allah responds to you. And this is why you ask them instead of asking Allah. You give up hope in Allah, but you don't give up hope in these people. You hope from them, you seek them. Realize that they will never create even as much as a fly. So why would you worship them? Even if they gather together for that purpose, forget the fly. Not even its wing can they make together. And if the fly should steal away from them a tiny thing, they could not recover it from them. They're weak before the fly. Weak are the pursuer and the pursued. So anyone who is worshipped besides Allah, relied upon besides Allah, we place our trust, our faith, our hopes in them. This is deception. This is deception. Because then we are pursuing who? The one who is weak. We can neither help ourselves, nor can they help us. Who can ultimately help us? Only Allah. مَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ They have not appraised Allah with true appraisal. Indeed, Allah is powerful and exalted in might. They have not estimated Him correctly. They don't think of Him correctly. They don't think about Him what is correct. They don't say about Him what is correct. They are so unfair. You see, the one who doesn't know Allah, he doesn't know the true status of Allah, he doesn't estimate Allah correctly, then he can never make dua to Allah. He can never continue to make dua. He can never worship Him. He can never be patient for His sake. And the one who does the qadr of Allah correctly, حق قدره, then he can worship Him even if people throw him in the fire. Like Ibrahim alayhi salam. He won't give up. He will continue. Allah yastafi min al-malaikati rusulan wa min an-nas. Allah chooses from the angels, messengers, and from the people. Indeed, Allah is hearing and seeing. He knows what is presently before them and what will be after them. And to Allah will be returned all matters. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, O you who have believed, irka'u, bow down, wasjudu, and prostrate, wa'budu rabbakum, worship your Lord, waf'alu al-khayra la'allakum tuflihun, do good things so that you may succeed. So if we want to be successful, what do we have to do? Worship Allah and do good things. And amongst the good things, especially ruku' and sujood. Why? So that we are successful. But is that it? There is more. وَجَاهِدُوا فِي اللَّهِ حَقَّ جِهَادِهِ And strive for Allah with the striving due to Him that Allah is deserving of. You see, when you're seeking the pleasure of a human being, do you have to put in effort? You do. And if we're seeking the pleasure of Allah, then do we have to put in effort over there? Yes. We have to put in more effort there. So strive properly for the sake of Allah. Strive for Allah with the striving that is due to Him. He has chosen you, and He has not placed upon you in the religion any difficulty. So don't blame the religion. The religion is practical. It is the religion of your father Ibrahim. If he could do it, you could do it too. Allah named you Muslims before. Look at your name. What is your name? One who surrenders to Allah. So show surrender, show submission to Allah. And Allah is the one who gave you this name. Before, meaning in former scriptures, and in this revelation also. Meaning since the beginning, your name is what? Muslim. This is the title that Allah has chosen for us. So should we leave the title Muslim and adopt other titles that are based on division and hatred and sectarianism? That the messenger may be a witness over you, and you may be witnesses over the people. You have a huge responsibility, O Muslims. The messenger is going to witness over you. He will say on the Day of Judgment that, Oh Allah, I conveyed it to them. And you have to be a witness over the people. So establish prayer and give zakat and hold fast to Allah. Because otherwise, you cannot succeed. If you want to be successful in anything, what do you have to do? Establish prayer, give zakat, hold fast to Allah. You know, any step that a person takes for the sake of Allah, Allah will test him in that. Allah will test him in that. So for example, Ramadan fasting. Few days is easy, but then let the 10th day come and you will wonder how many days are left. Right? It becomes difficult. We are human beings. So what do we need? We need strength. We need greater iman. And where do we get that from? From Allah. So for that, what do we have to do? Establish prayer. Establish prayer. Pray properly. And pray more. Pray what you have to and pray more. Pray the qiyam at night. Pray nafl. Ask Allah for help. Give zakat. Spend so that you are spent on. And hold fast to Allah. Remember Him. Hold fast to the book of Allah. He is your protector. Only He can protect you. And excellent is the protector. And excellent is the helper. So why don't you do something to deserve His help? So that you can reach a level which you would not otherwise reach. You can reach success. You can be successful. You make something in this life. So take the help of Allah. And for that, you have to first of all struggle, and then you have to pray, worship Him, do what He has commanded, and He will help. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. يَدْعُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ He invokes instead of Allah that which neither harms him nor benefits him. That is what is the extreme error. ذَلِكَ هُوَ